Assalamu alaikum, dear students. Today our topic is types of relative clauses. Now there are two main types of relative clauses. Number first, we call them as defining relative clauses, and number second, non-defining relative clauses. Now in some grammar books we find they have other names as well. Defining relative clauses are also called as identifying relative clauses or restrictive relative clauses. Likewise, non-defining relative clauses are also called non-identifying relative clauses, or we can say non-restrictive relative clauses. Let us take up defining relative clauses. As the name suggests, defining relative clauses, they identify or classify nouns. So we can say defining relative clauses, as the name suggests, they identify or classify nouns. They tell us which person or thing, or we can say which kind of person or thing is meant. So defining relative clauses, they identify or classify nouns. They tell us which person or thing, or which kind of person or thing is meant. Now I will write here two sentences. Number first, the man is coming for tea. Now here, the man is coming for tea. This is not clear which man is coming for tea. Now another sentence. The man who wrote this grammar book is coming for tea. Now here, the man who wrote this grammar book, we have here used a relative clause. It defines or identifies this man. The man who wrote this grammar book is coming for tea. Now in the first sentence, we don't know which man is coming for tea. In the sentence second, we know about this man because this relative clause identifies or defines this man. And the meaning is much more clear in second sentence because we have here used relative clause. So we can say in defining relative clause is essential to the clear understanding of the noun. So in defining relative clause is essential. Number second, the relative pronoun that is often used in defining relative clauses. So we can say relative pronoun that is often used in defining relative clauses. And number third, commas are not used in defining relative clauses. So we don't use any comma in defining relative clauses. Let's take some other examples. For example, people who take physical exercise live longer. People who take physical exercise live longer. If we remove this clause, who take physical exercise, then we have only people live longer. But it does not identify people under discussion. If we write only people live longer, it does not identify people under discussion. So for identification, we need here a relative clause. Who take physical exercise, it defines the people, it identifies the people under discussion. So this is the relative clause and this is defining relative clause. Another, the bag which or that I bought yesterday was stolen. Now here, the relative clause is which or that I bought yesterday identifies, defines this bag, and this is again defining relative clause, we have used it here. Now non-defining relative clauses, they do not identify or classify. Non-defining relative clauses, they do not identify or classify. They simply tell us more about a person or thing. So they tell us more about a person or thing. Or we can simply say non-defining relative clauses, they give us extra information about a person or thing. Now for example, my brother who lives in Delhi is a doctor. Is an engineer. My brother who lives in Delhi is an engineer. Now if we remove this clause, who lives in Delhi, if we remove this, then there remains my brother is an engineer. So if we remove this clause, who lives in Delhi, even then the message is clear. So who lives in Delhi, this is here just the extra information. As it can be seen from this example, in non-defining relative clauses, commas are very essential, commas are very important in order to separate important information from the extra information. So in non-defining relative clauses, we use commas. Why we use commas? In order to separate the important information from the extra information. And number second, in non-defining relative clauses, we do not use relative pronoun that. Instead, we use who for people and which for things. So in non-defining relative clauses, we do not use relative pronoun that. In defining relative clauses, we often use relative pronoun that. But in non-defining relative clauses, we do not use relative pronoun that. Instead, we use who for people and which for things. And comma is very important in non-defining relative clauses in order to separate important information from the extra information. Now, if commas are not used, the meaning of sentences can sometimes change. I will write here a single example to explain this. For example, children who learn quickly should start school early. Number second is, children who learn quickly should start school early. Now, in the first one, no commas are used. Children who learn quickly should start school early. the relative clause, it defines or it identifies what sort of children should start school early. But in the second one, while we have used commas, it means the meaning of this relative clause sentence is that all children should start school early. Here, who learn quickly, this is just the extra information. And last thing you have to remember, non-defining related clauses, they are used in formal writing. Now, I hope you will remember these things so that in defining relative clauses, no commas are used. In non-defining relative clauses, you should use commas to separate the important information from the extra information. Thank you.